Hello, 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 and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on my Series X, and on the planet of Pertum, in the wake of 1.198. Why are we here? Well, a little bonus video for you, as there have been some changes. One of those changes is in how lightning works. It was always meant to be attracted to decoys, but it didn't quite work. So in 1.198, Keen Software have actually fixed lightning, so it will now be attracted to decoys. What that means is that my self-repair lightning rod tower is redundant in the design that I showed you in the one video way back on Pertum on the beta before we had mods, etc., etc., on the retail. So I'm here today to quickly show you how to build one of these that will work versus lightning. So first of all, you start off with a battery. Now, for this to work, make sure that the battery is touching, or rather in the ground, because this grid needs to be grounded. So you can start off by building your battery. Now, we used to build a decoy atop the battery, but now we pop an armor block. And on top of that armor block, we want to put a cargo container. Then, to keep the battery powered, we're going to throw a wind turbine. Finally, what we need is a welder. Excuse me. So now we've got the beginnings of the tower. We can also throw stairs to make it easier to get up. Now, the next thing you want to do is you want to get to your decorations, rather to your decorations 2, and you want to find the steel catwalk plates that have no sidings on them whatsoever. You want to put them, to begin with, like this, on both sides of the tower. Then you want to move away, you want to rotate until this is the trickier part. This is the important bit, though. Aim your cursor onto the block, like that. And then finally, you want the magic plastic. There it is. Decoy. So now, we go to the welder. And we turn the welder on. Then we're going to bring in we'll do it directly into the welder using the spawn menu. We go down to some steel plates because these lightning rods repair themselves. And to do that, we want steel plates. Classic, forgot to select the steel plates. Always remember now, you have to select things. You can't just bring the thing down. It's one thing I always forget when I'm doing anything in the game. I always forget that you've got to press on the thing you use now. Spawn it into the targeted container. So we've got steel plates. That is our self-repairing lightning rod. Like that one there. It may take a few minutes, but if we go to our admin menu, remember I showed you how to use all this in one of the videos that came previously. You want the electric storm, and you want to create weather. We might have to sit back and wait a few minutes for the storm to generate enough static electricity to create lightning. Lightning may not strike the particular tower I've built. I've got several towers, so if you see lightning go off, you'll see that it is drawn towards these towers. This is my second Pertum save that's in creative that I use for showcasing mods as well as my Earth-like. You may have seen it if you watched the Wasteland DLC showcase. See some lightning going off there. Distance, that will have hit one of my many towers. Good thing with this is it's self-powered, so when lightning hits it, I'm going to repair the decoy, and power is going to be charged into the battery from the wind turbine at the back, and it only needs a very small amount of power. I'll see another bunch of lightning strike off over here. Several. There you go! And there's the tower repairing itself. It's got 19k in there. The lightning strike. Yep, plenty going on over by the base. These storms can be pretty vicious, so decoys are a must on Pertum, and building a self-repair rig like this in survival is actually quite easy once you unlock the correct parts. If I remember rightly, decoys come off the one branch that has the personal defense turrets. But you can always open up your progression tree and see where things come from. By holding down the left bumper, tapping left on the D-pad. Yep, that is your self-repair lightning rod, and how to convert my old tower into the new design is really simple. Just remove the decoy that used to be there, put an armor block in the way, remove the blast block that was there, replace that with the decoy, and you're good to go, protected from lightning storms on Pertum or any other planet that has lightning. And these will offer about a 50 meter radius protection. And you can see some of the new blocks from Warfare 1 in this little fortress. And you could also use these windows as great little skylights. They look kind of cool. There it is. So, tomorrow we will be looking at Flare's Star Wars repulsors, so stay tuned for that one. And on Sunday, rather than a mod showcase, I'm going to do the first part of the survival on planet. So you've seen the admin menu, you've seen the menu, the new game menu, all the settings and so on. I'm going to look at how to set up a base like this, but on Earth-like. I may do a series of videos with other planets like Pertum and the alien planet, because they all have their own separate needs for survival. There it is. One last lightning strike. Very the protective tower in action. Let's move this weather. And I will say, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. Remember, this is the Year of War, and there is more to come. Field Engineer is just one of a series of updates, and I will, of course, cover any major changes, any new features, and anything else coming to Space Engineers that's cool. Bye for now. Ta-ta.